Hello everyone! So today we'll be talking about magnets. So what are magnets? Well, you might have heard of them. And so they have basically steel rods with two poles, the north and the south pole. And the earth also has poles and it has a north and a south pole. And this magnetic field protects it from solar radiation. And so north attracts south and north repels north. So they attract and repel. And we'll be talking about two types of magnets in this video, permanent magnets and electromagnets. So how are electromagnets made? Well, all you need is a wire. It can be aluminum wire or copper wire. And if you don't have either of them, you can just get an aluminum foil and wrap that into a wire. Then you need a screw. And then what you should do is wrap the wire in a coil. And so as you can see in this video, in this image, just coil it around the screw and then put it in both sides of the battery, the remainder after you tie it, and then you'll have got an electromagnet. And so, how are electromagnets work? How do they work? Well, all you need is, let me just give you the animation. So, I have a copper wire, I coil it around the steel rod, and then I put a battery. Okay, so let's just look closer into iron. And so iron is a ferromagnetic substance. This means that it has lots of small magnets inside it. And so each of these magnets will both cancel each other out. For example, if one magnet's pole is pointing this way, then another, which pole is pointing this way, would cancel this one's way out. And so they would just cancel out. And this is why steel attracts magnets. But when we pass a current to them, this current with a positive charge here and a negative charge here, then we get we align the atoms inside the steel, and this is why we get a south set and a north set, and they become a one whole magnet. And so, how are permanent magnets made? Well, all we need is some ferromagnetic substance, as we said, iron, cobalt, or nickel will work. Or you could just take a natural magnet, like magnetite and lodestone. And if you have sand, you can easily do a small experiment to get the magnetite out of it. So sand is composed of quartz, but it's also composed of magnetite pieces. And these are all, you can call them magnetic sand, since the pieces of magnetite are all small magnets. And so if you just get a magnet, and then you wave it around in the sand, then you will get pieces of these magnetite. And one beach that has a lot of magnetite is Ocean Beach. It's full of magnetite. And so if you want to make it from iron, cobalt, or nickel, then what you have to do is you can do two ways. One, you can just do in your home. You just need to get a magnet. And then you just need to rub the north side onto one half of the steel, and then the south side on the other half. And so this would create a temporary magnet, since it will lose its magnetic field after 30 seconds. But if you wanted to create a permanent one, you would need to do something that you can't do in your house. You'll have to burn it, and not just in your oven. That wouldn't, it's not, I don't recommend you do it, but you'll have to burn it to 770 degrees Celsius. This is extremely hot, and this is called the Curie point, in which the small magnets, we said it out in the steel, will demagnetize and scramble around. When they do this, then we'll have lost these small magnets to interrupt us, and then we can just take another magnet after it cools down, take another magnet, and then all the small atoms, small magnets, will align with this magnet. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Bye!